a beautiful precious courage for it is
so what positive skin do you take out of the
repeat
tigers?
Say again?
What positive skin do you take out of the repeat tigers?
Look, I guess we set out at the start of my time here to see new players, and I think that we've seen some exciting new players in the one-day series. Lungi Ngidi made a debut. Henrik Claassen made a debut, and Henrik Claassen's been excellent, I think. Junior Dahle in this T20 series was also very good, and we saw a little bit of Christian Jonker tonight, and he also played an outstanding innings. So I guess losing is never easy to take, but you know, when you're missing so many of your seniors and then some new people come in and make and put their names forward, then the result of the series is hard to take. But then you obviously have to look forward to the future, and the future with some of the youngsters seem like it's going to be a bright one.
It's been quite a dramatic falling away of the South Africans after the second test. I know the injuries have obviously been major factors. Mm-hmm. But are there other things which are maybe worrying to you that you've seen quick then?
Not really. I think if anything, you know, you take the seniors out or the guys that were injured, and then the new guys that came in, the level and the intensity at which they have to perform has been different to what they've been accustomed to, and they haven't stepped up or they haven't been able to adapt quickly enough. You know, I think we've seen, like I said, some exciting new talent. And when you look at the series on the whole, the experience of India told in the end, I think.
Things like younger players coming in and performing well, and it's almost like you've rewarded quite a lot of domestic players.
Yeah.
How much do you then think about some of the players who are part of the team now, maybe who aren't performing, and then need to go back into the domestic system and find form?
Well, I think you remember the very first, even before I got here, all the players were asked to play domestic cricket. So I'm a big fan of a strong domestic league or tournament will then produce better players for international cricket. And if you have international players that are not performing, then I would think that domestic cricket would be the place for them to go back and raise the standard of domestic cricket so that it becomes a little bit better. You know, so those guys that haven't performed, that have done in the past, you know, there are a lot of guys that haven't performed well this series, even in the one-day series, that have been good players for the country in the past, you know, and people can always be out of form. That's part of sport, and it is just then how you bounce back and the attitude that you have towards practice and preparation that will help you to get back to where you want to be or where you belong in terms of your form. So it is just a case of those guys being very clear in their minds what it is that they need to do, and I'm sure that I will help them along the way with some of the things that I've seen that I think that we can do better as a group.
So you're quite happy with the standard of domestic cricketer that's coming to international
league? No, I didn't say that.
No, that's what I'm asking. I mean, if you look at the young guys like a Lungi or a Junior Dahle or a Christian Jonker, you know, they
perform well, and therefore they should be credited for that. They perform well, but the gulf between domestic cricket and international cricket is still quite a wide one.
Yes.
Yeah, as a former fast bowler and experienced coach, what do you think has been the difference between South African and Indian bowling in the power play? It seems that India have had a better hang of power.
Experience again, experience. You know, so India has got Bumrah and Bhubaneswar Kumar, two very experienced players. We've got in this game, in the last two games, we've got Morris and Junior Dahle making his debut. You know, so the experience that they have of, I guess, even playing for India, but also playing 3 or 4 years of IPL cricket, has told in the end. But Junior, I thought Junior held his own very well, and Chris Morris has got a lot of work to do.
Yes, sir.
Tonight I wasn't. No, I think when you look at the game tonight, we lost by 4 runs, and the difference tonight would have been fielding. You know, I think drop catches, sort of individual errors in the field, fumbles, would have cost us the game tonight. Other than that, I thought it was a very good game.
You've got the seniors coming back, some of them at least, or you've done it too many days to prepare for the Australia. Is that a huge relief for you that you've got some of those players coming back?
Well, for sure, the seniors in any team makes it stronger, you know, and we, especially with the seniors that we have coming back. Our captain missing has been a massive loss, Faf. You know, we hope that AB's body is better than it was in the one days. We hope that he's somewhere near 100%. I'm not sure that he will, but he'll be somewhere near 100%, and he can take his place in the team. Even Dale Steyn is not far away again, you know, so the seniors, we've missed the seniors this series, there's no doubt about that. You know, so having them back, I'm pretty sure will give everybody a lift.
You said Chris Morris has got quite a bit of work to do. He's been left out of the test squad. What does he need to do now?
Well, I would imagine he will go back and play some domestic cricket. He's obviously got the IPL whenever the IPL starts, I'm not too sure. But before that, he's got some domestic cricket to go and try and get some consistency in his bowling, especially. You know, we know that he can be a match winner. He's been very short of that, and you know, we've had a conversation around that, myself and him. So I'm not telling you anything that I haven't told him. So you know, he just needs to decide what type of bowler he wants to be, and then. Put the practice in or put the work in to become that person, because he's a match winner.
We know how much you like in the test side and how much you wait for the full face performance,
yeah.
And the wickets that we have. Can we expect a similar thing against Australia?
Well, it's a different opposition, so therefore the sort of makeup of the team might be slightly different. We have to get to Durban and see what we get. I think the last time we tried to speak to the groundsmen, everybody knows what happened at the Wanderers, so we've left the groundsmen to prepare the best possible pitches that they can this time, and then we'll see what happens after that. Okay? Beautiful. Thank you.
Thank you.